Now let's start defining some basic operations on vectors. The first operation we will describe for vectors is addition. One way to visualize the sum of two vectors is to lay them end to end. The arrow formed, starting at the tail of the first arrow, and ending at the head of the second arrow, gives the overall total amount of change by the two vectors. This new arrow is the sum of the first two vectors. In addition to this geometric interpretation of vector addition, we have a numeric interpretation. Given the first two vectors as a list of coordinates, we can add the two vectors by adding the corresponding coordinates of each vector. Since this first vector is 1, 2, and the second vector is 3, 1, their sum vector is 4, 3. Notice that if we lay out the vectors in a parallelogram shape, the sum vector connects the points where both chains of vectors start, in this case the origin, and where the chains both end. We can subtract vectors in addition to adding them. Here is the geometric interpretation of vector subtraction. Consider the vectors v and w, both emanating from the same point. What vector would we need to add to w in order for the sum to be v? We represent this geometrically by drawing an arrow from the head of w to the head of v. This vector is what we call v minus w, since w plus the vector v minus w equals v. Numerically, we can compute the difference between two vectors by subtracting their corresponding coordinates. So, taking this vector to be 1, 3, and this vector to be 5, 1, their difference is minus 4, 2. This is reflected in our drawing, since the difference vector represents a change of 4 units to the left and 2 units up. This time, if we look at our parallelogram formed by x and y, notice that x minus y connects the heads of the two initial vectors in our chains. If we reverse the direction of this arrow, we'll obtain y minus x. Another important operation on vectors is scalar multiplication. In this case, a vector is multiplied by a number which we call a scalar. The term scalar is suggestive of the word scale, which is fitting because the geometric interpretation of scalar multiplication is to scale the size of a vector. Multiplying a vector by 2 doubles its length. Multiplying a vector by 1 keeps it at the same length. Multiplying a vector by 1/2 cuts its length in half. We can also multiply a vector by a negative number. This reverses the direction the arrow points, in addition to possibly growing or shrinking the vector. Numerically, scalar multiplication is computed by multiplying each coordinate of the vector by the scalar. So 2 times the vector 1, 2 equals 2, 4. And negative 1/2 times the vector 3, 2, 1 equals the vector minus 3/2, minus 1, minus 1/2.